Hey guys, one of the really great things about the Boss GX100 is how flexible the onboard assignments can be. And there's basically up to 20 different parameters that you can assign at any given time per preset. So that's super flexible. And I'm finding that I can get through basically a whole gig using only a handful of presets because of all the different assignments that I can make within each preset. So let's have a look at how you would set that up. If you've just received your Boss GX100 and you want to completely customize how the pedals are set, here's how you go about doing it. So the first thing you want to do is hit the control expression pedal button. And you can see that we've got different functions here. The first thing you want to do is go into the control function button, because this is how you set the global state of each button. Now, you can set it to memory, which means it can be configured freely per preset, or you could set it to a system button, which means every preset would have that same functionality. And for me, that's not completely flexible. That's not how I like to run it. I like to run it as a memory, which means it will be assigned on a per preset basis, not globally over the whole unit, okay? So you can see I've got the bank down button to memory, bank up, memory, control one, control two, both set to memory. Similarly, if we bank across here, expression switch, memory. I'm not using a control three or a control four pedal, but if you had an external control pedal attached to your GX100, then you would set those accordingly. Then I've got the expression pedal set to memory, as well as the current number. And the current number is the preset that is currently selected. When you toggle that switch, it will trigger some different functionality based on what you've got set up in your assignments. Okay, so that's how you would set up your pedal's global functionality. Okay, so if we just exit there, so now you've set it, so you've got complete control over every single switch on the GX100. Okay, so as an example, if we exit out of here, and I'm just gonna go to, say, let's go to a different page view. Okay, so we're looking at a page view here that has the blocks present. Now, as an example, say I wanted to set the bank down button to toggle the overdrive on and off. At the moment, I can toggle it on and off by basically going to effects here and just toggling on and off like that. However, if I want to set it to the bank down button, what I would need to do is add an assignment to it. So I'll go into the control expression and we go into the assign settings. Let's say, for an example, I want to set number one to toggle the overdrive on and off. Currently it's set to current number and it's toggling the delay on and off. But hypothetically, say I want to change that, I want to make it set the overdrive turn on and off. So rather than current number, we're going to use these four knobs here, and they correspond directly to the four columns that are currently on the view. So I'm going to turn this first one to the bank down. So now that's saying whatever I've got set in these next columns will be applied to the bank down. I'm setting it to toggle, which means I'm turning directly on and off. If I set that to momentary, it means it'll only turn on while I'm holding the switch. As soon as I take my foot off the switch, it will turn off again. Okay, so I'm gonna set it so that it's toggling. So when I hit the button, it'll stay on until I tap that button again. Okay, and currently it's set to delay. We don't want the delay. You can see in this top row of blocks, you can see the brackets around the delay. If I just turn the button, you can see that it's moving across, and I know that the yellow one is my overdrive, and the parameter is currently set to on and off. And that's pretty much all you need to do to be able to turn. You can see that the switch has now turned yellow, which corresponds with the block, and the number is lit green. Now, if the select button is pressed, you can see that it turns that off. So if your assignment number is not lit green, it means it's not active. Okay, so you need to make sure you press select to activate that assignment. But let's say now that I've got the overdrive toggling on and off, and I also want my gain, or say the solo switch on the amp block, to also toggle on. So let's do that. So let's go down to the next assignment. So now I'm in the second row here. It's already enabled, but it's currently set to the expression pedal. I want to change that first of all. So we're also now assigning it to the bank down button. It's also toggling, but it's currently set to the wah. So I'm going to change that so that it's moving across to the amp block. So now it's set to the preamp. It's turning the preamp on and off, but I don't want the preamp on. I don't want the preamp on and off. I want the solo switch. So we're going to use the parameter button to find the solo switch. There it is, solo switch. So now what happens if I exit out of here, and if I go into the amp block here, go here, and we'll just page across to the solo switch. Now you can see that I've got the overdrive off and the solo switch is off, but when I press the pedal, both the overdrive and the solo switch now turn on. So again, you can assign up to 20 different functions per switch if you're per preset, but you can assign any of those 20 to any switch you want, if that makes sense. So super flexible. You can set the current number. So how I've got my GX100 set is so that basically when I hit, I just exit out of there, we'll go back to here. So I've got it set so that when I press on the same current number again, the currently selected preset, it's turning on delay, reverb, solo switch, giving me a little bit more level. It's giving me the overdrive. So basically it's setting my rhythm tone to a lead tone just with the singles press of one button, and that's pretty flexible. So hopefully this opens up a few possibilities for you in setting assignments and getting the most out of the presets that you've got in front of you on your GX100. If you found this video useful, I hope you'll consider liking and subscribing. It really does help the channel, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks. Bye.